Hello, good evening. Love it or loathe it, the Brexit bill has the power to change Britain's political wiring forever. People have just 3 days to decide if they like what it says. They were given their first full sight of it tonight. The moment they left, or walked out, they left. I'm joined in the studio by Katie Balls from The Spectator, Stephen Bush from The New Statesman, and down the line from Belfast by Suzanne Breen of The Belfast Telegraph. Let's start with you, Suzanne. I'm curious to know, we've seen your front page, but how that felt today.
Well, there's a very, very momentum.
When you think of, you know, you saw the picture of the Northern Ireland Assembly of Stormont, they couldn't come back over this. What do you think will return, sort of power sharing or a pickup of government in Northern Ireland?
It's very hard to see it happening anytime soon. We've heard Theresa May say she wanted to restore power sharing. Boris Johnson, when he was running for leader, said it's something he was going to prioritise. But yet, relations between the UK government and the DUP are an all-time low over Brexit. You look at the current relations between the various parties, and it's just hard to see a way through. The one thing I would say is Julian Smith, the Northern Ireland Secretary, I think has respected it a bit more than Karen Bradley, his predecessor. But there's still a long way to go.
Stephen, let's pick up with what we think is going to happen tomorrow. The programme motions, this incredibly complicated way of saying how much time everything gets, essentially.
Yeah, but it is, I think, probably...
Yeah, we say.
And really, the only way that coalition holds together is if people can squint at the detail.
Suzanne, when you're looking at people squinting at this deal, I mean, you know, one side of it, and the people who really made the big difference on Saturday were, of course, the DUP. Now, is it right that they're going to back pretty much any amendment that will scupper things for the government now? Are they on the warpath?
Well, watch over...
Talk them down.
I think it's very hard to see...
Oh, sorry, I was just going to come to Katie.
I think it's very hard to see how Boris Johnson can talk around the DUP. Boris Johnson is very optimistic, but I think even his level of optimism shows that there's a problem there. Ultimately, the government has to find votes away from the DUP to get things done in terms of the Brexit deal and in terms of the programme motion. I think that broadly the 21 Conservative rebels are beginning to come round to the programme motion, but there's still a couple who aren't so sure about it. But if Brexit is going to be done by the 31st of October... And clearly some would say it won't be done in that sense. But if the first stage is to be completed and the UK is to leave to the EU, this needs to pass tomorrow. And if it doesn't, we're looking at potentially an extension and a general election.
So, Stephen, this says the PM may axe the deal as Berko blocks the vote. Do you think we're about to see the end of this or about just saying, thunderclap now, stop, and we start again with an election? Thank you all very much indeed. Thank you. That's all we have time for this evening. We'll be back tomorrow. It's going to be a long day and a big one in the Brexit negotiations, but do hope you'll join us then. Good night.